Finally, a video on how to mod your SNES controller to connect to your Wii controller using the nunchuck and a chip from RAFnet. Let's see if I can get a focus here on the camera. Oh, there it is. Now, you want to start with the Wii nunchuck. I want you to take it apart, take the screws out. Doesn't matter what nunchuck you use. This is a third-party, $3 cheap little nunchuck. And, you know, I got it in black so it could match. The wire can match the SNES's original wire. Once you take it apart like so, you want to take out this part, the board and the wires, because that's what you'll need. Now, what you could do is grab the part and cut here past the strain relief. And you're going to want to keep this part for reference for later. And you can cut this off. That's just me. I usually cut it off so I could have the wires free. Now we can move on to the SNES controller. And we're going to need, of course, the connector for reference later. Now to get into the connector, you're going to have to push these four tabs all around. You could use a flathead screwdriver. It's kind of tough, so if it doesn't work on the first try, don't give up. And make sure you're willing to damage this connector, because I was, and you're pretty much not going to use it again if you're going to convert this NES to a Wii controller. Now, once you've got it off, you can just cut right above that golden part. And now you can save that for later. Now you can unravel the long wire that is the SNES controller. Once you've got that down, you can open it up. And now you can unscrew the five screws that hold it on there. Now we can open up the SNES controller and take a look inside. Now we can see what we'll be working with. Unravel the wire. And now you can take out the board from the controller. Now you can cut it so you don't have to have the whole wire hanging there the whole time. This is what you're going to need for the whole mod. Now let's start with the board and the chip. We have to find a placement for the chip. There's a close-up view of it, and those pins are pretty much where the wires are going to go. But where can we put it? I found out that the easiest place to put it is here in the middle, right next to the connector. That way it won't get in the way of anything when you close up the plastic case. Now this is the schematic I'm going to be using, and we're going to start with the data cable from the SNES connector to the PC2 on the chip. And I'll show you. It is the fourth one from the bottom. Now, just need to pop open that connector. And now you can see all the wires on the inside. Pull out the red one. Because that's the one that sits in the fourth spot. And now you know, the red wire is the one you're going to use to put into the PC2 spot. Cut it into size. Strip it. and tin it, or you could just put it into the chip and then solder the wire onto the chip. Now the next wire we'll be doing is the latch, which is the third one from the bottom. And as you can see, it's the orange wire. Same operation, cut it, trim it to size, strip the wire, tin the wire or put it into the chip, and then solder it in. Whatever operation is easier for you, whether tinning helps you or not, I would recommend doing so. The next one we'll be doing is the clock, which is the second one from the bottom in this schematic. And that's the yellow wire. Same operation. Cut the wire to size. Strip the wire. Tin the wire, or just put it into the board. And then solder the wire to the board. Now we'll be doing the Wii controller. So what we need to do is strip some of the insulation. So what we can do is trim it. Don't trim too much. We want enough for slack, but we want the wires to be able to fit as well. Now, if you take a look, there'll be a few pins that won't be used, just like there won't be on the chip. And the first one we're going to do is the clock, which is, if you look at the schematic, the bottom right, if you're holding it towards you like that. So, you trim it, strip the wire, you tin it, place it on the board, and solder it in. Second wire we're going to be doing on the Wii Nunchuck is the data, which will go to the PC4, which would be this blue wire. Same operation. Cut it. Strip the wire. Tin it or place it on the board and then solder it on there. Next, we'll be doing the ground for both the SNES and the Wii, which is white and brown. So it's white for the nunchuck, as you can see here. And brown for the SNES, which is the seventh one from the bottom. Same procedure, be careful. Trim both wires to fit. Strip both wires. Tin both wires or place them on the board and solder them on. Now we'll be doing the V plus on the SNES and the detect and V plus for the Wii Nunchuck. On the Wii Nunchuck, they're brown and red. On the SNES, it's the white one. Same procedure, trim all the wires to size. Strip all the wires. Now tin all the wires or place them on the board and solder them on. Now that we've gotten everything soldered in, we can place the board back onto the case. I'd like to hold it down with a glue gun just to make sure it's not bouncing around inside. It doesn't take that much. You could put a little drop just like that. And once you flatten it, it'll hold the chip in place. Make sure to put it as centered as possible. Run the wire through so it can act as strain relief. Place the cover back on. Make sure it closes correctly. And if there's a little push from the wires, that's okay. The screws will hold them down. Now let's test out our new SNES to Wii controller mod. Now, connect it into the Wii controller. Now let's turn on our Wii. Alright. See if this thing works. Let's play one of my favorite Super NES games. Sorry, the TV's behind me. Still behind me. Alright. If it gives you this message, just tap on the SNES and it should be able to detect it. Now, I'm gonna reset it so I could just start from the beginning. And we can test it out very quickly. So far it works. Let's delete the last one. Seems like it's responding very well. This screen doesn't help very much. Can't do anything. Alright. Left, right, left. So let's see what we can do. Jump, jump, jump. Spin. These two buttons don't really do much. Except for this. Up, down, up, down. So far, the controller seems to be working out. As you can see, it's responding very well. One thing I need to mention about this is that the SNES isn't programmed, so you can't use it on the Wii's main screen. So you can only use it once you're in the game itself. And that may be the drawback from the Pro Controller, but this is the original SNES to your Wii controller. It's pretty cool. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how to mod your original SNES controller to connect to your Wii controller. Enjoy.